here's how Lauren Graham got to the winner's table. Lauren disarmed the table with her giggles and played aggressively right from the start.
Nice.
She had exactly the same cards, but she betted a lot better than Matthew.
Chris Masterson jumped out to an enormous early lead, knocking out Sean Astin on the fourth hand of the game.
Sean is out. Chris has doubled up.
Lauren kept trying to make them think she wasn't quite sure how to play.
Then the options, as we see them, are what now?
Lauren finally took over the chip lead when she knocked out Sarah Rue.
She's out, and Lauren is our new chip leader with a huge pot there.
Then she knocked out Matthew Perry with the help of pocket queens. When they got to heads up, Lauren kept up her gutsy play as she tried to lure quiet Chris into a concentration-breaking conversation.
Tell us something about yourself, Chris. Where were you born? Do you have any pets?
She also kept up her passive-aggressive play.
I'm betting this many purples.
Oh, the orange. Okay.
Thanks.
It's so many numbers.
Then Lauren finished Chris off when she caught him trying to steal with the worst hand in Hold'em.
Can you beat that?
Lauren Graham, with some aggressive play, has taken this title and will advance to her championship round.
She played coy. She played dumb. She played great aggressive poker. Lauren Graham used her card sense and her acting skills to earn herself a seat at the championship table. Here's how Maura Tierney got to the winner's table. Had her work cut out for her. Tennis player James Blake jumped out to an early lead.
Twos of spades on the river, and James has doubled up.
Maura finally took top spot when Jon Favreau ran into her pocket kings.
Maura takes down the biggest pot of the night and really cripples Jon.
After Jon knocked out Andy Richter, James Blake took back the chip lead.
James takes the chip lead with another good bet.
But that didn't slow down Maura.
I'll bet 3,000.
Maura wins the pot.
She knows how to get a crowd on her side.
I'm going
to
go all in.
Nice play, Maura.
Then she eliminated Tom Everett Scott.
I'll go all in.
Big hand for Tom.
James knocked out John with pocket kings.
River is a king of spades. John can't win. James wins the pot.
And as they started heads up, James had the lead. But Maura would change that on the first hand.
Your kicker's gonna get me.
Maura wins the pot.
I think we might need two shots at
tequila.
The lead bounced back and forth like, well, like a tennis ball.
Maura takes the chip lead.
The fun continues.
And before long, it was game, set, match.
I can't win.
I think you're about to.
River is a jack of clubs.
Jack on the river. Maura Tierney's taking it home.
Maura Tierney played solid poker all night, and now she's sitting where she belongs, at the championship table. Dule has pocket fives. You know, Sammy Hagar can't drive 55.
And it's also Dule's favorite hand.
I'll make it 1,000.
Dule is raising to 1,000.
7-9.
Good race. Good race.
Rosario folds.
Obviously, you gotta look at your cards. You can't
I guess I should look at the cards around you.
King five.
I'm trying to gauge your reaction of my reaction of looking at my cards.
Oh, okay.
I picked up a tell on you.
Michael folds.
King seven for Lauren.
I'm going to raise.
Lauren is raising. Lauren raises to 1,600 total.
Uh-oh.
Dule calls, two players.
At ace of hearts, nine of diamonds, eight of clubs on the flop. Dule has the best hand with a pair of fives. Lauren has no hand.
2,500.
Lauren bets.
And yet bets 2,500. This is a stone cold bluff, guys.
And Dule is taking it serious.
And I don't see how he can call this.
Dule, 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 go.
I'm fold.
Dule folds. Lauren wins the pot.
Lauren Graham's aggression just takes that pot right away from Dule.
There's so much staring going on.
I know, it's like, so I feel uncomfortable, you know? Everyone keeps staring.
Like, when I played before, it was like, oh, like...
It was more fun.
Everyone was sort of just doing their thing and, like, staring at their cars, making all these, like, crazy reactions. And and they were just all about and they making jokes. It was like Wanda Sykes. She was just like...
Do you wish you had your other game here?
No. This is cool because it's just getting, like, mad heavy. Like, everyone's just sort of like...
Well, your turn, Rosario. Your turn.
I know. Thank you, though. Appreciate it.
Well, this game's more serious than her game because it's championship night. There's $150,000 at stake here for the charities tonight.
It's raised.
Rosario raises to $1,200.
Queen two for Michael.
Michael folds.
And Lauren Graham has a 4-8 suited.
Lauren folds.
But Mara has the 8-10 of clubs.
Is that right?
Mara calls two players.
Six of hearts, ace of hearts, deuce of diamonds. That flop missed everyone completely. No one has a pair.
I'll bet 1500.
Mara's betting 1500.
This is an extremely aggressive bluff.
I can feel you staring at me, dude. Like, it's like, damn strong. All right, I'll call that.
Rosario calls. Turn is an ace of diamonds. Mara's first.
Ooh.
3,000.
Mara bets 3,000.
And Mara's coming in to get at her.
She fires another bullet at this pot. Stone cold bluff by Mara. And there's no way Rosario can call that.
Rosario falls.
And my dear old friend Mara takes that one.
I was due. I'm Maura Tierney, and I'm playing for the Children's Aid Society Teen Pregnancy Prevention Program. My level of expertise is very non-expert. I think there is beginner's luck. There's a looseness I think you have when you don't quite know what you're doing.
Is that right?
Mara calls.
I think the jury's still out over whether I'm good at it or not. So I want to try to do everything the exact same way.
Mara wins the pot.
A winner. It says winner. I'm a winner. Good to know. It's in print.
Rosario's first.
And Rosario's king to a diamond.
Rosario folds.
5-2 for Michael.
Michael folds.
Lauren Graham's got another hand worth folding.
All right, it's up to the blinds now.
7-8 of hearts for Mara.
Mara calls.
And we got a queen 5 of diamonds for Dula Hill.
Dula checks, two players. Flop is ace of hearts, 9 of hearts, queen of clubs.
Dula has the best hand with a pair of queens. Mara has a flush draw. She's got 2 hearts in her hand and 2 hearts on the board.
500.
Mara bets 500.
2,000.
Dula raises to 2,000.
That's a great play by Dula.
All right, I'm going to play.
Yeah! Mara calls. Turn is a jack of diamonds. Mara is first.
Jack of diamonds does give her a straight draw. A 10 would make her a straight, or a heart will make her a flush now.
I'm going to raise you.
Okay.
I am. Just tell me from now. I'm going to raise you.
But I'm in such trouble. Check.
Mara checks.
2,000.
Dula bets 2,000. Mara falls. Dula wins the pot.
And Dula played that hand just absolutely perfectly.
What did you have? You didn't have it, did you?
I'm not going to tell you.
No way.
I'm not going to tell you anyway.
Yeah, but you didn't have it.
Gives you a Mara's steady hand, first. That Jack and Coke.
Nice.
King 6 diamonds for Mara.
All right. I'll raise 1,200.
Mara's raising 1,200 to 1,600 total.
Okay.
He's our chip leader right now.
Pocket kings for Dula.
Cowboys, that's a great hand.
I'll make this 3,000.
Dula raises to 3,000.
Rosario's got an ace 5 of hearts.
That's a good fold facing a raise and a re-raise. Folds.
King five for Michael.
Michael folds.
And Lauren has an ace-jack offsuit.
Now, this is normally a good hand, but facing a raise and a re-raise, I think you got to throw this hand away.
I will call.
Lauren's calling. Mara calls three players. Flop is ace of clubs, nine of hearts, nine of clubs. Lauren is first.
Lauren has the best hand with a pair of aces.
Notice Lauren looked down at her chips.
Yeah.
You can tell she got a piece of that flop and she wants to bet, just because as soon as the flop came down, she looked directly down at her chips. But it's important to notice those kind of things when you're at the table, because, it, for instance, if she were to check, you'd be very unlikely to bluff in this situation if you knew that she wanted to bet.
Because, Phil, who are you playing against out there? Are you playing against little pieces of cardboard?
No.
No, you're playing
human beings.
Against human beings.
I'm going to bet 4,000.
Lauren is betting 4,000. Mara folds.
Mara, of course, folds, and it's up to Dulé. Now, when an ace comes on the flop and you have pocket kings, it is very important that you don't lose any more money when people show strength.
That's a call. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, I'm going to raise.
Evidently, I forgot to give Dulé this lesson.
Dulé is raising to 8,000.
I'm going to raise you on the next hand, too.
I've heard this before.
And I did.
Well, we didn't find out.
I would have, though.
Because I f***ed out and pulled him.
All in.
All in.
All in. All in.
Don't listen to them. But do go all in.
Don't go all in.
I'm all in. I'm all in.
She moves all in. This is our first big confrontation of the night.
All right, I'll go all in too. Let's make it hot.
And Dulé calls her in a shot. He has officially lost his mind.
Wow.
Do or die, baby.
He's almost drawn stone cold dead, because we know both the other kings have been folded already. Mora had a king, and Michael Ian Black had a king.
3,900 total.
Oh, well, I guess I'm not going all in then.
Dulé has more chips, so even if he doesn't win this hand, he will still be in the tournament. He'll be very short stacked, but he will still be in the tournament.
Turn him over.
Dulé needs a club on the turn and a club on the river. That's only going to happen 5 or 6% of the time here.
And a jack of hearts. Dulé has a king of hearts and a king of clubs. Let's see the turn card.
Here we go. Oh, queen of clubs. That's a great card for him. Now all he needs is one more club.
Lauren still has the best hand with aces and nines. Let's see the river.
Here's the river.
River is a four of diamonds.
Lauren doubles up, but Dulé is still in the game. He's got a couple of thousand left. That was a huge, huge pot for Lauren. Wow.
Shuffle up and deal.
All right, after that last disaster, Dulé is down to the felt.
Yeah.
Don't count him out, though. Anything can happen.
Rosario is first.
8-5 for Rosario.
Rosario folds.
Michael's got a king, 7.
Michael folds.
6-9.
Lauren folds.
Mora, king, 6.
I can raise, right? I'm forgetting how to play poker. So I'll make it 16.
Mara is raising to 1,600.
She's going to raise enough almost to put Dulé all in.
Queen jack of spades for Dulé.
Dulé is going all in for 1,800.
And this is a good hand to take a stand on. It's only 200 more for Mora to call.
200 tomorrow.
Really?
You can't fold.
I can do whatever I want to do. What's it to me to play?
$200.
Okay.
Mara calls. Dulé is all in. Let's see both hands.
Well, you're going to go now.
Dulé shows a queen of spades and a jack of spades.
She has a slight preflop favorite here, about 60-40.
Six of spades. Let's see the flop.
I just want to get you back in the game.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
We'll see.
Flop is four of clubs, four of diamonds, nine of clubs.
That is not going to help him. Now he's down to six outs. He needs any queen or any jack.
Let's see the turn. Turn is an eight of spades.
That's actually Dulé a decent card for Dulé. Now he has a 10 for now. He needs any of the four 10s, a jack or a queen, or else he's going to be joining us here in the Loser's Lounge.
Let's see the river. River is a queen of hearts.
He sucked the queen out on the river. He's still in the tournament. Wow. This is the land of the river.